Hello, beloveds. Welcome back to our channel. And we are the... So as we all know, since the pandemic started, millions of people around the globe have lost their jobs. Yeah, so I lost my job and until now, I'm still unemployed. So ang kinakarir ko ngayon, I am pagbibake.
I'm a little bit lucky because I teach English online. So my career has not been affected by the pandemic. Actually, I gained more students.
Despite the pandemic, I feel like I'm really blessed because I still got job going as a healthcare worker.
For me, nothing much changed. So I'm still teaching.
I'm also working online. Technically, I'm like working for two online companies.
I'm working as a researcher. Yeah. Never had lockdown. And yeah, life goes on.
My major is biology. After graduation, I applied for help.
Thank you, Mom Ching.
Since I started, I'm still here in this field.
I studied Bachelor of Science in Elementary Education. Actually, only applied for two places, help and another. And that was my first, job.
Ikaw ang nag-major ng education, pero ang ending mo, health worker.
I graduated PS nursing. I went to help while waiting for the result of my test. But I still decided to stay because I enjoyed teaching.
I finished political science. My very first teaching job is actually a private tutor. And then when I graduated, I was with another English school. I think there were also lean number of students there. I saw an ad of help. So that's the time that I got into help.
In my 5th year university, taking accountancy, I thought of taking a part-time job. Yeah, and my first was Academia di Sofia International. After that, I applied for help.
Graduated with a degree in BS Biology. I went to Manila after graduating teacher, and I applied for science teacher. And then they said, we actually don't need science teacher now. Can you teach English? I quit that job. I went back to Baguio City and then the relationship with students, learning new culture, learning about Korea, learning about the students' different personality.
So with this kind of job, I was able to, meet a lot of people. And with teaching, I was able to, nag-level up yung confidence.
I really enjoyed the growth in their growth personally, dealing with people, English, sa teaching. I thank you.
Oh yeah, the art of communicating. Hindi ko namamalay, na-enjoy ko na talaga yung pakikipag usap sa kanila. Nag-enjoy na ako sa work. After work, nag-enjoy din. Pwede kang mag-read. Gagawin mo yung mga hobbies mo or you go shopping after work.
Wala ka nang shopping.
Mayaman
ba ang ESL teacher?
I started teaching ESL. I was barely 20 years old. Parang 19 years old pa nga ako. Yeah. Teenager. Was my adult formative stage. Dito ako nag-grow talaga. Dito ako naging me. Actually, wala akong talent. I think hindi ako marunong kumanta. Pero I think I found my talent in teaching.
Yeah.
But really, the best part was making my character by meeting other characters. Kung hindi man lang sa students ko, from other teachers too, and from other people in general.
Doon na enhance ang aking communication skills. Enjoy kong makipag daldalan sa students, like exchange of cultures, culture na sa Korea, sa Japan.
After 10 years, sabi ko, okay, I need to change my career. Pumunta ako ng China. Ang ginawa ko doon, nag-book ulit ng English. Bumalik ulit ako dito sa Pilipinas. So I went to school again. Pero while going to school, I'm still teaching English. I couldn't change my career. I'm still thankful that I have this job because it still pays kahit na may pandemic. Ngayon, may side hustle na ako. So as you know, I'm into real estate. I got my license na rin. Natrinay ko rin mag-insurance. I'm also a licensed
broker
agent.
And learn
to gradually shift to that field. Para
after health, pumunta ako sa public school for a few years. But due to status change, I was a full-time mom for 2 months. And pumasok ako as a healthcare assistant. So in the near future, I want to be a full-time mom. While doing that, I am really looking forward to applying my study ko na nga small business management.
Fine. So I've decided to look for other opportunities. Anyway, from ESL to Montessori teacher, change ng students from talking about talks with adult students, culture, social issues. Napunta ako sa Baby Shark. So I'm enjoying my work now. But I don't see myself doing this for a very, very long time. Kasi nandito ako sa ibang bansa. Pag-uwi ko ng Pilipinas, maybe mag-apply pa rin ako na employee sa isang company. But I will have to have many sources of income. So yun.
Actually, I quitted health because I got too excited to go to China. But then, my visa got denied. So because of that experience, the desire to go abroad was, really strong. Dating ako sa Saudi. So the job says daycare teacher, but it was more of caring rather than teaching. My first few months there was really tough. Anyway, and after that, of course, Christine was living her life in Vietnam. It's like, okay, come on here, blah, blah, blah. Okay, let's go to Vietnam. Tapos, di ba, feeling ko ang yaman-yaman nila nung pumunta sila sa Vietnam, di ba?
Billion nga yung pera dun eh.
Yes. Experiences there, so usually for kids then. Yeah. Anyway, I got back here in the Philippines for my side hustle. If I'm going to turn it into a business, of course, that would take like a lot of money. And I think dapat mag-upskill ako, learn new skills related to freelancing.
I was in help actually. I realized my love for teaching. And an opportunity came, so I went to Korea for grad school. I realized na gusto ko ng research. What I can see myself doing in the next years is to go back to the Philippines, apply in a university, and if I can do both, they call it research professor. If I can do research and teaching at the same time.
Yes, I went to Vietnam and then I taught ESL pa rin. And then, nagturo ako ng kindergarten, which was the hardest part of all. So, nung pandemic, naisip ko, okay for me to go back to the Philippines and then siguro after a month or two, makakabalik ako ng Vietnam. Pero that didn't happen. Money-wise, what is the fastest way, easiest way? To work as a kindergarten teacher. Yeah, back in Vietnam, something like that. And at the same time, gusto ko rin i-start yung freelancing, yung pagiging virtual assistant para.
Be brave, especially when you're starting out. Madaming negative things from other people and from yourself. Alam mo yung hindi ko kaya. Maybe I'm in the wrong field. I'm in the wrong profession. I'm ganon. And daming mga questions. So be brave. Do it. And then when you're not happy, be brave then. Quit the job and then find another thing.
Find something that excites you. Yung nasa likod ni Gina. Do what you love. You just have to keep on trying. Like actually, there are many options out there. You have to work hard to look for something that really suits you. And come prepared. That's it.
I know it's hard. Yeah, challenges are always there. I encourage you to focus on the positive side of it and how you grow.
First, embrace change because we can't always stay in our comfort zone. And second, be willing to grow, never stop learning. And third, when you make decision, panindigan nyo na. No more what ifs, wala nang sisihan, regrets sa kung anong hindi nyo pinili. Always aim for excellence with the job that you chose.
Just to encourage you, it's okay. It's okay not to know right now. It's okay if you're feeling tired. It's okay if you're feeling discouraged at the moment. You're entitled for those emotions. But then, sabi nga nila, you move forward. Fear can paralyze you. You need to move forward. Right? Tapos yun na, hone your skills, learn more, meet people who are connected to what you want to do. sabi nga nila, pinagdadaanan lang daw ang problema. Hindi pinag-listo.
Oh, basta wag tambayan.
There are many opportunities out there. The opportunities won't find you, but you have to find them yourself.
I have one more advice. Don't go to the ESL field.
Alam mo naman, dun ang passion nila. Actually, it was a good start for me.
Help was a good training ground.
Grabe kayo, si Ate Ara.
That's it for today, guys. So we hope that you learned something from us. And we would like to shout out to our 100 subscribers. Thank you for watching. See you in our next video. Bye. When I wake up, I feel cozy, yeah. Can you hold up?